Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name is Paul. Today we're going to have a look at what is in this box. This is the new Ubiquiti Dream Wall. Really excited about this product. It's what I would see part of the maturity of being able to put something that is very similar to the Ubiquiti Dream Machine Special Edition, but in a wall mountable. It looks much more like a battery pack. It's going to fit in your garage or your wherever your room is, your comms room in your house. It's going to fit really nicely and fit and look much more in line with things. It means you don't have to have a rack to bring all your cabling to. It's got everything thought out. So I'm just going to show you what you've got in the box. All right, we'll have a look at this properly in a minute. This is the device itself. Going to do my best to hold that up to the camera. It's 10 kilos in weight, so we'll see where you get to. All right, you are going to have a power cord. These have got, I'll try and hold this up for you. These have got their new locking pin in the side. I'll show you how that works in a bit. I'm not sure whether it will see these in Australia, but it's a normal IEC connection anyway. This is a European model, so it's got a European power connector on it. You are going to get your little conformity guide as always, and you're going to get your little QR code get started guide. Now, this is a wall mountable device, so you are going to get a wall mounting bracket there. The idea being that you're going to screw this to the wall. I will show you how it all fits together. And there's a lever on the back of the Dream Wall that allows you to clip it in place. And it locks as you drop it down. Maybe ease it down, not drop it down is probably the word. You're also going to get a packet of lugs and screws to be able to mount that. Now you're all saying, I want to know what the device is. Show me the device. So let's have a look at this first. All right. The outside, probably not a lot to show you, and it's probably going to reflect quite a lot on the light. So I'm going to hold this up for you. You can see the screen there in the front. We've got a small touch screen, very similar to all of the other USW switches, the UDM Pro and UDM Special Edition. All right, on this side here, we'll have a look at it in a moment. We have two removable power supplies for failover. All right, we have got on the bottom here our cable in for our mains. We'll have a look at it in a moment, and our release switches for this lid. On this end here, all that we've got is our nice cable tidy with all of the cable holding there for each of the switch ports. Hopefully you can see that. I'm aware that the camera may not have focused super good. Let me bring this around this way so you can have a proper good look there as well. So let's have a look at the power supplies. I believe these are about 550 watts in total. They are fully removable, so we're going to push them in like the doors on a UDM or an NVR, and out comes the module there. Just show you the back, the sides, and the front. All right. So you have two of those in this unit. You only have, it's interesting, mate, you only have one power cable in, and then obviously it's split between these two power supplies. So like I said, you have the second one in here as well, exactly the same. So those are your removable power supplies. Let me show you how this is meant to be mounted first. So obviously the idea is this is going to be mounted directly on the wall. Haven't shown you the back of the unit yet, so let me show you that. What you can see here is, well, probably more exactly, you can see the air vent cooling slots down the side here, hopefully. And you can see, let me hold it this way, you can see a bar that comes out and pulls out like that. So if we now take our mounting bracket that I showed you earlier, we're going to pop this onto our wall in the position that we want. Try and show you how this is. You're obviously then going to be able to slowly release your unit into it and push it and clip it into place against the wall. Again, your action of being able to pull it out and up to take it off the wall. So really, really sturdy fitment. That's going to look pretty neat on a wall. So what else do you get with this? Well, let me just pop those two buttons here on the bottom. All right, and that's going to allow us literally now to take the lid off the unit. Let me just pop that down somewhere. I'm not going to damage anything. All right. So let me just lift this up to the camera, hopefully an angle that you can see all of the switch ports. Probably can't hold that there forever, so I'll bring it back here. You have over here a 10 gig SFP port. All right, and then we have four groups of four switch ports. Let me just pop those up again for you. So you have four standard non-PoE ports. You then have four PoE ports. So each one of those can do a maximum of 15 watts a port. We then have four PoE plus ports. Each one of those ports can do 60 watts a port. And then we have four PoE plus plus ports, which can do 60 watts a port. Now, there's no specific published overall power for this unit at the moment. So I'm guessing that it's probably going to be about 400-ish watts, maybe 440, 420, depend on the exact final specifications and probably generally everything else that is running on that. But obviously you have you have good number of ports there already on the top. Yeah, four ports, you got 16 across the top plus the one SFP, which is your starting point. Then let's bring this unit round for you. Obviously, this is your LED screen that we had shown earlier. Then if we turn this around, I'm hoping that you can probably see through this. So your power cord is going to run up to here. We have got a little cover that we're going to take off. This is going to be where our mains power is. We can see our locking pin on the side there, hopefully, that you can use. All right, now over here we have a 10 gig SFP WAN port, a 2.5 gigabit Ethernet WAN port. So you're going to obviously get 1 gig and up to 2.5 gigabits on that switchable. And you get a normal 1 gig Ethernet port there for your LAN as well. So that is your input. So you've got three switch ports on that side, like I said, just to double check. Yep, three switch ports on there. Then you get a little bit extra over here. So we've got our reset switch and we've got our SD RAM card. Now, as you will have noticed, there's no place in here to be able to put a hard drive like you would see on the UDM Special Edition or the UNVRs. This has, I think it's 16 gig of eMMC standard RAM. It has 128 gig of additional storage RAM in here, so it can run your cameras. This can run the whole Ubiquiti Suite Access, Talk, Identity, Protect, and Network. It can run all of those, and you can upgrade the RAM with an SD slot. Obviously, there are some speed issues there maybe for you, but it does make this a fantastic getting going unit for your whole house. So let me just lift that up again so you can see all the way around it. So here are our switch ports, and obviously our cable tidies are along the front here. Nothing to show on this side. Obviously this is where our cable power comes in from the bottom all the way up. And then obviously on this side, as we've mentioned before, here are our removable power supplies. So hopefully that's been a good look. Also built into this is a Wi-Fi 6 access point, very similar to the AC Lite. It's a 2x2 dual band, so 2.4 and 5 gigabits a second. I'm sorry, 5 gigahertz, not even speed, getting confused there. So 5 gigahertz. So both of those can run simultaneously. So obviously you're getting 16 ports there, of which 12 ports do PoE 2.3 to PoE++. You've got a 10 gig LAN SFP port. You've got a 1 gig Ethernet LAN port. You've got a 10 gig SFP WAN port. And you've got a 2.5 gigabit a second Ethernet WAN port. Two removable power supplies. All in a rack mount, or all in a wall mount unit, along with that Wi-Fi 6 access point. So a great starting point. Really excited to see these in mass production before long. There is another model, I believe, that's coming, the Dream Wall Pro, which has got a bigger screen, a few other extra options, which we'll have a look at as soon as that's released. So hopefully that's been useful. Do head on over to our YouTube channel. We've got loads more box openings on wireless networking and firewall devices, how to set up Unify Network, how to set up Unify Protect, You can find it all over there. So please do subscribe and stay up to date. Hopefully that's been useful.